Someone please give me a new chapter. The chapter 100. Because I'm about to go crazy. This chapter is so freaking crazy. I hope that it's an April Fool's prank. Like, since this was released on April 1st, I kind of feel like maybe Byeonduk is, you know, pulling a big one on all of us, that this isn't really a real chapter, but like when chapter 11 comes in, that it's just a big haha, happy April Fools, but by then it's gonna be April 7th, so I don't know what she's pulling, but this is not a very good chapter, guys. Before we get started, I just want to remind our viewers that if you like seeing more yaoi content and would like to support this channel, please don't forget to smash that like button. Also, if you haven't done so, please subscribe to this channel and hit that notification bell. Feel free to message me in my social media at ZealedFujoshi, which I'll be using to interact with viewers about more yaoi content. If that is something that interests you, feel free to follow me at ZealedFujoshi. Finally, this episode will contain explicit content and a lot of manhwa spoilers. With that in mind, please proceed with caution. You have been warned. Now, without further ado, let's jump into chapter 99 of Painter of the Night. Can we take a moment to say how scared Sungha is in this chapter? Can you see how he's running around like a crazy fool just to find Nayeom? I am absolutely impressed. I kind of feel that after reading chapter 99 till the very end, I wish that I have the patience to actually wait for more chapters, because chapter 99 is a very stressful chapter. I mean, we actually do get the answer that we've been looking for. Min has confessed that he is the one pulling all the strings, and he even lied to Jiwa. So, guys, let's establish this right now. Sungha is innocent. Sungha did not do anything wrong to Inhan or to anybody. Like I said in the previous episode, this was all Min's fault. And I can't believe that I'm about to say this, so if you're under 18, please turn off your whatever and... this is gonna be stressful. Anyway, so now that Min has his hands on our poor baby Nayeom, he is about to jug him and do the big R on him. Well, in order for Min to actually catch Nayeom, he has to like hit Nayeom with a 2x2. And so, like, our poor Nayeom is bleeding too much right now. And sadly, our baby Nayeom is about to get drugged. And of course, so stressful. He's about to be... what's the perfect word here so that I don't get demonetized? You guys know what he's about to do. I don't have to spell it to you. Oh my gosh. And going back to the whole Min situation, I have to give him kudos though. Like, all of the planning he did in order for him to get Nayeom is really way better than how Jiwa initiated his kidnapping. I really have to give this man kudos for everything he accomplished by now. It's so stressful. I'm just trying to laugh it off. But first and foremost, Min... remember in the previous episode where Min... well, we didn't know it was Min. But the mysterious figure always wears this weird color that I am always confused whether it was green or whether it was yellow, and sometimes I would call it yellow-green. And so I wasn't the only one confused by this color palette that Byeonduk is basically... Byeonduk basically did that on purpose to confuse all of us, because I think Byeonduk knows that we're onto her, that we know that the whole Min gang is like wearing this weird green color and Jiwa is always wearing this weird yellow color. And this mysterious figure, we were always on a debate whether the Hanbok is green or yellow. And in this chapter 99, we were not the only ones confused, because apparently the other Kaesongs were also confused whether this mysterious figure was actually wearing green or yellow. So it was purposely played out that way. And because Min is letting the Kaesong house think that he is Jiwa. That's why when Jiwa saw Min with Nayeom and Hannah, even Jiwa was confused, like, why are you wearing those clothes? Because I guess even Jiwa knows that that's not his regular clothes, that weird shade of green and yellow is, you know, a combination of Min and Jiwa's color palette or something. So I really I was so excited when I saw that particular Easter egg was finally answered. So it was a clue on the color of their hanbok, but it was purposely misleading that way, that if you're just basing it on each house's hanbok colors, you were meant to get confused, because this mysterious figure, which is really Min, was wearing a combination of both green and yellow, because Min is trying to make people think that he is Jiwa, because he's about to put all the blame on our poor Jiwa. Oh my god. This poor guy, like, he can't catch a break. Like, he did the failed kidnapping, let Nayeom go, and then got hunted by Sungha. Now he is a pawn in all of Min's plan, and it looks like he's about to be the scapegoat in Min's plan. So I really hope that Jiwa will learn his lesson by now, that Min is not his friend. I mean, I think he knows he's not his friend, but he should really do his moral compass thing again and do the right thing. It's gonna be hard, because we know that Sungha is angry at Jiwa for the whole kidnapping situation before, or the whole Lord Song before. But I think he just has to make it right by saving Nayeom again. And it's gonna be hard confronting, or at least talking to Sungha, but I think that's what we're gonna get. I think. Going back to Sungha, everybody is yelling for Sungha by now. And while I agree that where the hell is his Nuna right now? Like, is this what Hannah was really thinking of when she was thinking that they're gonna be safe with a nobleman? Like, come on. Like, she should have known better that Min is a two-faced snake. And there is no safety going with Min right now. We kind of know where she's going, though. It looks like Min is set on killing both Hannah and Nayeom. Nayeom is only after he does finish his deed with Nayeom, but it looks like Hannah's about to be sent to the slaughterhouse right now. But I kind of feel bad for her, because she fell right into Min's plan, and I know she feels bad because she was not a good judge of character. It doesn't matter right now because they've already fallen in Min's trap. And I just hope that Sungha really comes as soon as he can. If it's not Sungha who's gonna come and save Nayeom, I do think it might be Jiwa. Maybe this is Jiwa's redemption arc. Or maybe Jiwa will call for help, which is going to be no name at this point if he does ask for help. Because that the salvation of Nayeom really falls heavily on Jiwa right now, right? We know at the end of the chapter that Min is telling Jiwa to go grab opium because of course he wants to drug Nayeom to submission. So if Jiwa leaves this house, he can either go straight to Sungha and Sungha will either tell him show me where they are, or Sungha's just gonna slash him down right there or right there, like he's not gonna get up after the slashing. Or because Jiwa is too afraid of facing Sungha, Jiwa might actually go straight to No Name and let No Name handle this whole situation. That could work, since I think No Name can, you know, stand pretty fairly with Sungha, an angry Sungha. But if that would be the case, where not No Name is the one who's gonna approach Sungha, Sungha is gonna be wary of a Jester, right? Because Sungha knows there's something up with Nayeom and Jesters. And on the night that Nayeom is missing, if a Jester were to approach Sungha, oof, that's not gonna be a pretty sight. But all of these really heavily relies on what Jiwa's about to do in chapter 100. Jiwa, my dear, I know that you are better than Min. I know that you're better than this. I think majority of this fandom, even though they hate Jiwa, knows that Jiwa is a good person. Because remember, Jiwa did let Nayeom go and spared Nayeom's life on the first kidnapping. I just really hope that Jiwa will be brave enough to go against the evil Min at this point. How he does it is gonna be the highlight of chapter 100. But I'm gonna be a little bit salty. I'm not gonna put my blame on anyone else aside from Henna. This is all her fault, to be honest. I hope that at least Byeonduk will give us a chapter where Henna realizes how silly she was to have trusted Min, and she was played by Min. And I hope that we at least see that chapter where she repents on all of those bad mouthing about Sungha. And since we are at this point where our baby Nayeom's about to get manhandled, I really hope that Sungha will come soon and just castrate Min altogether, or just slash his head off. I don't know. Just bring back Sungha from chapter 1 where he's so okay. He's very much, he doesn't feel anything about killing anyone. So I wish that Sungha will come back. Anyway. Anyway, ladies, we all know that by the end of this current season that we are in, we know that someone's about to drop dead. And I really hope that it's Min. And I really hope it's by Sungha's hand. I hope, for Min's sake, that you enjoy your little time with our baby Nayeom. And I hope you don't hurt him, because if you did, you will face the most cruel death. Man, I can't believe that Sungha is like moving so slow right now. He better rescue him fast, because if anyone touches Nayeom, it's gonna be over. The man's bleeding like profusely right now. Somebody better bandage this man up. I also want to make a request for Byeonduk. If you are listening to this podcast, I wish that you would give us a chapter where Sungha skinned Min alive. Like, I just really want to see that episode. Sungha can even like make a jump rope out of his intestines when he finds Min at this point. Like, oh my god, if Byeonduk would just do that, I would be so happy. That would be the most perfect revenge. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. Please don't forget to follow my social media to be teased about some of the boys' love that I'm interested in. Feel free to leave me a message and converse with me in my Discord channel. I'd love to hear back from you. And please consider supporting the show by donating as little as 99 cents through www.sealedfujoshi.xyz. Also, don't forget to support the author. All the manual details can be found in the description below. Again, thank you so much and hope to see you next time.